begin our journey into the world of Let's Play.
Isaac and his mother lived alone in a small house on a hill. Isaac kept to himself, drawing pictures and playing with his toys as his mom watched Christian broadcasts on the television. Life was simple, and they were both happy. That was until the day Isaac's mom heard a voice from above. "Your son has become corrupted by sin. He needs to be saved."
"I will do my best to save him, my lord,"
Isaac's mother replied, rushing into Isaac's room, removing all that was evil from his life. Again, the voice called to her. "Isaac's soul is still corrupt. He needs to be cut off from all that is evil in this world and confess his sins."
"I will follow your instructions, Lord. I have faith in thee,"
Isaac's mother replied, as she locked Isaac in his room, away from the evils of the world. One last time, Isaac's mom heard the voice of God calling to her. "You've done as I've asked, but I still question your devotion to me. To prove your faith, I will ask one more thing of you."
"Yes, Lord, anything,"
Isaac's mother begged. "To prove your love and devotion, I require a sacrifice. Your son, Isaac, will be this sacrifice. Go into his room and end his life as an offering to me to prove you love me above all else."
"Yes, Lord," she replied,
grabbing a butcher's knife from the kitchen. Isaac, watching through a crack in his door, trembled in fear. Scrambling around his room to find a hiding place, he noticed a trap door to the basement hidden under his rug. Without hesitation, he flung open the hatch, just as his mother burst through his door and threw himself down into the unknown depths below.
Hey there, guys. Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to my first ever Let's Play. My first ever Let's Play on this channel. So, as you saw, we're playing The Binding of Isaac. I will talk about the story a little bit, but we're going to jump right into it and just get started with a new game. There are other characters to play in this game, but we have not unlocked anything on this game. As of recording this, Steam says I have only had 30 minutes into this game, and considering this game came out in 2014 and I actually bought it more or less around that time, safe to say we've got a lot of work to do. So we're playing as the base character in this game, Isaac, and if you saw that introduction, also to note, I made the first mistake of any Let's Play rookie, which is I left my cursor on the screen. So, we don't need to do anything with that yet. So, cursor has been removed. As I am also, as a viewer, I also get slightly ticked off when that happens. But, you know, I can now understand it's an innocent mistake. So yeah, this is the first ever Let's Play series on my channel, or my attempt at a Let's Play series. I've played other games, you might have seen them. Me and a group of friends have played Dead by Daylight together. We play quite a bit of... generalization, but we play a League of Legends, but to be fair, most of the people I bump into or meet seem to also play League of Legends. So I almost just assume that is the norm. I probably am wrong though. But yeah, I've been looking for a Let's Play to do on my... Did we go to the item? Oh, we got Rainbow Baby. Okay. I've been looking for a Let's Play to do on my channel for a while. Like something I can do regularly. And I also wanted something that was a bit more challenging. And I couldn't really think of a better option I'm gonna have to focus here, so give me a second. We'll get back to the train of thought in a moment. Yeah, commentary's probably, we're gonna have to work on that. Don't expect there to be maybe stellar commentary. Watch out for the creep, watch out for the creep. Keep the flies. Oh, thank you, Rainbow Boogie, for the slow shots. Yeah, I don't think I can talk yet until... Ooh, thank you for taking out your brother. I gotta say, the screams are actually kind of cute. Oh, no, damn it. Alright, one hit. You know what, for a rookie player, that's not too bad. We get our health back. We get this. As I was saying, had to concentrate there because I was determined not to die to the first floor boss. I don't think there's anything else we can do on this floor. There is a secret room that we could go to, but with one bomb, it almost doesn't make sense. So we're going to just head down to the next floor. As I was saying, looking for a Let's Play series to do on this channel. And I couldn't think of a better game to make that a game to choose for that series than the game that got me into Let's Playing or as a viewer. So this is a game that came out in 2014, like I said, and I've been casually following Let's Plays of this game since then. So I thought it'd be interesting because I've got a lot of background knowledge on this game, so I know about boss patterns, I know about enemy types, I know about items and possible synergies, okay. But I do not have muscle memory or the reflexes, which this game is kind of, like, you will get better with this over time. I do not have that part of the equation. So I thought it'd be pretty interesting to see how my knowledge but lack of reflexes can translate into me actually playing this game. Ooh, wait, isn't that... That's anti-grav, which is actually okay. Oh, actually, no. I'm so used to watching Let's Players take this that, I actually thought it was a good item. You know what? All things given, it's actually not that bad. okay. These guys should be kind of easy because you can just wait them to chasing you down Pac-Man style. There we go. One more to go. Yeah, it's gonna take. It's actually very hard to talk while playing this game. There's a lot to focus on. But yeah, we'll get through this slowly. There's a bomb. There's a tinted rock. And where was I going with this? Do we want to use our key to open that? We'll fight the boss first. I'm never going to finish my train of thought at this rate. But hopefully, if we don't die too soon, we will get through. He does three, right? Yep. See, this is where the knowledge comes in. Like, I know he does three charges. Oh, damn it. No. Oh, wait, we have a spirit heart, which means there's still a chance. Charge at me. Come on, charge at me. Yes, you go. One more. Oh, one more. There you go. Nice summoning. Boops! Okay, if we can finish him. If we can finish him, we still have a chance for... No! Right, so I've just taken red heart damage. Which I shouldn't take any more. But, we've just lost our chance at a deal with the devil, which is basically a bonus you get for not taking any damage on a floor which is a really big advantage for you to get strong. I'm kind of gutted because given that this is my first playthrough, and we unlocked an item. Oh, I was really hoping to get that deal of the devil. That would have like really given me a lot more confidence in my mechanics. So yeah, as I was saying, there's a gap between my mechanics and my knowledge of the game, which I thought would just be interesting to see how it plans out. Here's another chance to demonstrate what years of, as a viewer would think, years of watching people play this game will have given you, based on the secret rooms basically that are spread across the map in certain, and they can only appear in certain places. I'm pretty sure it's on this one or the one next to the, no, it can't be next to the boss room. So if there's a secret room here, then there you go, and we got a lot of money from it, which technically means we could even go to the shop now. I don't have any bombs, so I can't go. I'm gonna go to the shop. I've got two keys. I will buy Mom's coin first, which gives you four pills. Hope, and we will take them because I've learnt from the best that sometimes throwing in a bit of RNG is good. So I think it's Q for taking pills. Range up. We won on that one. There's two of these, so hopefully it's good. 48 hour energy is kind of useless, but we can take one down with us. Explosive diarrhea! Run! Ow. Okay. It's all good. And so, can't use that. We'll take this pill down, because if we get a space bar item, and we'll take a spirit heart to hopefully try and get deal with the devil in the next floor. We have a key. We could open that chest. I really shouldn't, but I'm tempted to. I'll do it. And we got another spirit heart, so you know what? I'm totally okay with that. It's actually, yeah, I knew I'd like this game. I bought it for that very reason, but I just never had a chance to really play it. And then now just feels like I want to do a Let's Play. I can't think of another game to do a Let's Play with. Oh God, Curse of the Darkness. So, as you can see, can't see a thing on the map. I'm not sure if, I have a feeling he turns up the brightness. You know what? He definitely does. Let's Play that I watch. Definitely turns up the brightness, I think. These are so annoying. I can, oh, we did it. We did it. Hop up, hop up, hop up. Oh no. I want my deal with the devil. Oh yeah, we got mysterious shot, but I do not want that. Right, so we're gonna cheekily turn up the gamma, I believe. To maybe 120? Is that gonna do anything? Does that help? I think that helps a bit. We're not gonna go through there, we're gonna shoot this poop. I don't know if taking anti-grav was the best idea. And yeah, it sounds probably, got one hit left before we lose our chance to get the bonus. Okay, done. Got a key. Fine, we need to find a tinted rock. Oh, this is okay. I can deal with this. Basically, as I was saying, I've said a lot of things to be fair in this already, so I think what we're gonna do for this series is keep it to one video. One run is one video basically. No matter how long that run is. Ideally, I believe the runs are meant to take between 45. I know you throw bones. Oh no! Oh damn it! We lost our deal with the devil. Yeah, I'm kind of glossing over a lot of the, what do you want to say, the explanations of this game. I think it's mainly because I'm, if you're watching this already, I believe you know what this game, know about this game, or have played it yourself. So, I might die here. So they pop up. Oh no, I can't see. Come on, pop up. Oh no. Yeah, this might be my death. Uh oh. No, don't box yourself in. I'm really trying to survive. Like, I could. How? What would I. Oh dear. No. What would I consider a success at this point? In this. Ooh, that was so close. That was a. Pop up. Thank you. No. Oh, we did it. Spirit heart. I kind of basically go. That was very scary. Which way do we go? Have I gotten my item yet? I don't think I have. Why is there a star there? Isn't that an item? No, it's a trinket. Can't go through there. We've got a spirit, even though it means nothing because... Ooh! It's a beggar. See, here's another strat I've learnt from years of watching. You put a bomb down, you kick it in, and you profit. And maybe we can get that one. And maybe we can get that one. Alright, one bomb for 5 cents is not bad. That's a self-sacrifice room. Put out the fires, because sometimes there's money or consumables here. I promise you, over the course of this series, my commentary will get more coherent as I reach a state of where I can play the game without having to fend for my life. But at the moment, it's tough. Oh, this is a terrible run. This is a terrible run. I think anti-grav is helping me because of the tier rate. Although I'm not near the tier cap at all, so I can't even say that. I might be just saying a lot of stuff that doesn't. If you've never seen this game, you know what? We're gonna start from the beginning. Hi there, my name's Dan. Today I'm playing Binding of Isaac. If you haven't played this game before, you may have seen the introduction, the cinematic introduction to this video, and basically you play as a kid called Isaac. Now, if you'll just give me one moment while I fend for my life again. Oh. No, this is bad. Oh dear. Does he not? Oh dear, me. Oh. One hit for the bosses, I forgot. However, we haven't. Oh, I hate you. we did it, and we might even get a deal with the devil. Yes, we got a deal with the devil. And we got speed and range, yes. Where are you? I shouldn't do this, as a new player. I shouldn't do this. I'm gonna take Dark Bomb, because I know he's good. And I'm going to take this, which is Guppy's Paw, which will convert. Ooh, yes, please. Oh, damn it. All right, I don't think there's anything on this floor that we can get, right? I'm gonna quickly double check. Do a once over. There's money there. But if I were a secret room, I would not be. Can I be there? I guess I could be there. Let's try. It's either here or over here. I'm gonna have a guess here. Yes! And more money, which is actually really good. Okay. Oh, see, that's where all the experience is coming from. Not going to the curse room. We may sacrifice one of our red hearts to protect our deal with the devil chance. Because there's basically that paw in the top left hand corner gives you spirit hearts. Three spirit hearts when you trade. And spirit hearts are the blue hearts. It gives you three of them in exchange for one of your red heart containers, which are a permanent health container, versus the blue ones, which are temporary. Anyway, before we start the boss, as I was saying, if you watch that cinematic intro, then... I don't think I'm... No. Nope. No, not today. Not today. Oh, damn it. I should have probably used Guppy's paw. Oh, that was nice. Happy accident. As I was saying, if you watch that cinematic introduction... You're basically playing the story of Isaac, whose mother went a little bit too deep into her religious activities. And so she basically tries to kill you. And you have, in order to escape her, thrown yourself into the basement. And you're on this journey to escape slash, I guess, kill her? Or defend yourself? Which I have to say, I never thought about this before, but you threw yourself into your home's basement. But at the same time, how big is your bloody basement? I didn't realize that the Isaac family were millionaires and had this much money. These are explosive which can be pretty dangerous. Ooh, we have no keys, so we can't go to that room, which is an item room. Every floor has one item room, which is... Oh, I hate these guys. Well, no, I know their attack patterns. You just need to not stand directly. You never want to stand... Except, you never want to stand straight in front of them, because as soon as they see you, they will lob a... they will lob a... projectile at you. Oh, we got a key, thank God. Okay. This is supposedly a really bad item. But I have Dark Bomb. I should be able to get some spirit hearts. Okay. We're gonna cheese this a bit. We're gonna use that. And hopefully there's... It gives you a random effect. What did this do? Oh! Okay. It gave me an attack boost for this room. Oh, but this is not... You know what? Let's take them out first. Okay, now it's more manageable. Got a bomb. Oh, I'm gonna charge up my own thing for it. Oh, I got a spirit heart as well. That's a big room. What do I get? And they get, oh, that will help somewhat. Ooh, the dodge. Make a defense. Make a defensive wall. Beautiful. Come at me. Do your worst. Okay. In hindsight, I don't think anti-grav would have been the best. Was the best item. But yeah, so the reason I've decided to play this game is because it's got a lot of depth to it. There is. Do I want to go in there? Yes, I do. Oh, see, I have watched the Let's Player I watch play is very risky. He's more of a high risk, high reward kind of play style, which I would love to be able to do, but I know that I do not currently have the skills. How do I kill that thing? Come. Oh, okay. Yes, thank you. Save me again. I don't. Have we found the secret? We did find the secret room. Which we didn't even need to. Okay. I'm playing myself a bit. Yeah. Which is not good. I don't have any keys. There's the boss room. I don't think we want to go in there yet. Now I'm just trying to find some consumables. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, that's good. Give me some help. I probably could have used that. Okay. That was a good use of I don't have any keys. I do have a bomb, and that will let me go into the shop. Wait, okay. Beautiful. We did it. See, because it's my first time playing this, I know you can only get, you're gated at how far you can get through the game. The game goes very deep, but... Oh, that's just wonderful. Right. We're gonna go and do a high risk, high reward play. Which is, we're gonna go into the... Not there. We're gonna go into the arcade and pray to God that something good happens here. Let's see what this does. I don't think it did anything for me. Ooh, actually, it gave me a red heart. That's not too bad. I'm gonna get this battery. I think I'm slightly faster as well now. I feel faster. I feel like my speed's gone up. What was that room again? The boss trap room? Was it the mob trap room? I can't remember. Okay, so here's... What do we do here? We've got three things we can play. We can trade HP for stuff with this guy. Oh, where's my guppies for? I know I didn't. What's in... What'd you give me? You gave me the chariot. Ooh. I just got a card from the Dead Sea Scrolls. It's actually treating me somewhat nicely. And I'm thinking... The chariot gives you invincibility. Which means... that we can play the stuff that gives me health. So these two. So we've got a... I think it might be better to go hard on the demon judgment. So we're going to do this. Oh, I'm nervous. So it's Q, right? It's Q. Oh, damn it. Gonna try and play this guy for something, maybe. Oh, a red heart. That's very nice. Another red heart. Go on, take it. But got something for me? Yes, you do. Alright. I'm gonna play one. Oh, humble bundle. Contract from below. This is not good practice. No beginner would ever do this unless you've watched someone play. So what pill we got? We got a question mark. Oh, damn. That's unfortunate. We're going to use up our money because... Although, actually, a better play would be... Yeah, actually, because the game finishes much shorter. Or it finishes earlier for the first time players. I think we won't be over an hour. I'll take this. I can't take the battery because I don't have the pill jar. Yeah, we're spending an unnecessary amount of time on this floor, but as a beginner, I think it's okay to take it slow and use the game mechanics to our advantage. So we take the battery, we get a pill. We hope it's a good pill. It was not a good pill. In fact, it was a terrible pill. And we may have just undone all the hard work that we had put in. Which is very sad to me. Okay, he gave me some money. That's nice. Oh, I don't actually want that. That protects us against flies. I've watched many videos of this people playing this game. But I've never wondered whether this thing actually has. Ooh, that's beautiful. Can we do anything with keys? I don't think we can. We got last cent. Oh no, well, you're dead. Thank you for the money. I don't think it's wise to play that. So here's the thing, here's the play. If we take a hit, we immediately push spacebar. That is the play to survive the boss fight, which I am very badly equipped for. Well, we've got two keys. We will open that. Got some money back. I am tempted to buy another key, but why would I need another key? No, we're fine. Right, boss time. Oh, it's a very tanky enemy. But I do know the attack patterns, so it's okay. Just make sure. Oh. Alright, we're safe. We have insulated. So you stand on the left side, move to the bottom, shoot, you get back on the left side. And then you dodge. And then you dodge. And then you dodge. And then you dodge again. Ooh. So you bait out. When his head disappears, you move. Is also to keep crowd controlling. Uh oh. I am super surprised I didn't get hit there. Oh, we're doing okay. We might actually win this. If I can complete a run without dying, I'm gonna be very proud. Oh, we unlock. There's many, many things to unlock. Take that. Go on, Dark Bomb. Take that and give me some health. Okay, spider. It is what it is. Shot speed upgrade plus a card. The hero font is great. I think we've done everything we can do on this floor. In fact, I'm going to be very risky. And we're going to go to that. See that room with the red? That is a curse room. And you take damage on the way in, and you take damage on the way out, but normally there is rewards that are worth getting. I just took more damage than necessary, but that is worth it. That's called Gimpy, and it means every time you get hit, there's a chance of you getting some health back. So I would say we have done pretty well on this floor. I'm going to buy an extra key just in case. Thank you. I need to donate this. There's so many things in this game. Like, it's actually a really deep and complex game, which is why I thought it'd be a fun challenge to actually try and complete this game. Because to complete this game, I don't know if I've already said it, all my commentary is kind of just meshed into one right now. But to complete this game takes a serious amount of dedication. But it's a fun journey on the way. Oh, we did something. We could really use more damage. Incidentally, I didn't realize this, but because I've been watching so much of this game, it also has a lot of expansions, basically. Even though it came out in 2014, it has, over time, had a lot of work, DLC. Paid DLC. Oh, damn. Thank you. Die. Please. Die. Please. Will you come up here? So we've got 5 bombs. These skulls can drop things for you. So we're gonna try. I think that might get 4. Yep. I'm gonna try this one. Black heart. Yes. Beautiful. So we've got 3 cards. We've got the hangman. Ooh, that might actually be a really good one. 2 of diamonds. Ooh, 2 of diamonds. Doubles our coins. Yes, please. The Empress gives us power. Flying lets us fly over rocks, crevices, and also lets us take half damage if we go into this room. So we're gonna go in, not take any damage, get 2 bombs, not worth it, and we're gonna leave. Which is fine. We're gonna use the Hierophant, which gives us 2 temporary spirit hearts. All in all, pretty good room. But yeah, as I was saying, there is a lot of them. Oh dear. There's like lots of expansions in this game. Oh, how did you hit me? That was unfortunate. Next room. Oh, this room's easy. One they can only move around on the edges. I'm glad I can take a break. But yeah, there's a lot of expansions, and one of the things that I've gotten used to is I watch a lot of Afterbirth, and right now I'm playing the base game with the intent to upgrade once I've actually made significant progress in this game. You know, as a little reward, I'll get the extra the updated version of this game. But I didn't realize this because I'm so used to, there's normally a HUD, I believe, that shows you like your damage. Oh god, this is not a good room. There's Gimpy coming in the clutch. Oh, thank you. Oh, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. We are doing less okay. Oh, we did it. Please take those and pay me some. So right now we've got actually a good amount of survivability thanks to the items we've got, but right. Okay. need to take these out. Luckily, these things can't hurt me from afar. I don't know whether anti-grav, which is what's making... Normally, you just fire straight, right? But right now, my projectiles are just standing in place, and when I let go of the arrow key, they go out. Oh, no. These are the worst! Okay, don't get inside your own head. It's fine. Like, you can very easily just... Okay. Oh, right. Wait. I didn't realize they take damage and just... maybe... Okay, anti-gravs is good against these enemies. I completely did not realize that. There's a shop. We're definitely going to the shop. A battery. I don't know how I feel about that. There's boss rooms there. I think we've only got like 2 or 3 more floors to go. Maybe... These would have been a real pain to deal with if I didn't have anti-grav. Thank God. You go into that room and you fight bosses. I believe. It might be bosses. Or maybe it's the just regular ways. I don't. Either way, I don't think I've got the confidence in my mechanics to be able to do that. Okay, so we've got a bomb. We should not mess this up. It's very hard to move. Right, so we put down a bomb, which is E, and then we push it in. That's good enough, right? And then we need to run across. Alright. Oh no. I did not. Unfortunately, I forgot that enemy jumps. Well, it's... Okay. Oh no. Okay, that's done. Why is there a bomb symbol there? There can't be a secret room here. Cross. Alright. We've almost cleared out the whole floor. You don't normally need to do this. Go on, that one. Yes, please. Thank you. It's possible that there's a secret room here, but it's also possible that there's a secret room here, which I'm going to have a guess and say here. Oh, yes. Sure. I don't know what I would hope for from this. You know what? No. It's better. Our money is better spent upgrading our shop. But first, we will kill the bonies, which is actually very annoying because my tears just get. Oh dear. I did not realize this is a thing! Uh oh. Okay. Oh, thank God. Double keys, thank you. Don't need it. I thought that thing. And we've got HP, which is great. I'm gonna put a bomb there and hopefully get some skulls. We've got nothing. That's fine. It is still fine. Wait, why is there a question mark there? Because it's the secret room, right? Yes. And there is actually a second secret room, which, you know, on every floor, but. I'm not too familiar with how that works. We're gonna donate to upgrade our shop, which in the future will mean... Okay, that's fine. And we'll take car battery. Because why not? Which, if we get a better space bar item, that will do... Oh dear. Oh, oh no, run. Okay, it's Monstro 2. The labor. So he just needs to. Just gotta bait out the. He's a very tanky boss, but he's actually not that hard to deal with. You know, risking it. Okay, we need to pay more attention. I want to win this run. So our last hurrah, this may be the end of the run. If I can just... Please don't summon any more enemies. Chance. Come on, we can do it. Look. Come on, one more. Yes. Oh. That was We have no HP. Could get some damage up. This game's very tense, and this is the final floor. So this is where you would fight Mom. We are definitely not prepared for this, since we only have 2 temporary HP. Oh no, I think these guys, okay, these guys are fine. These guys only fire in diagonals. We just need to build up our temporary HP. And these little babies. Alright, that's fine. That'll take them out. Blackheart saved me. Right. We are. There are spikes there. We are desperately fighting for our life here. Oh no. This is good. Okay. Well, turns out we're actually not that weak. Oh, excuse me. The commentary is probably going to be non-existent now as we are trying our hardest to... Oh yes, unlocked a new character. There are lots of these little challenges you can do, or... That's what I'm saying, this game has so much depth. It's gonna take us a while to actually get good at it, but then also take us even longer to complete the game. So I think it's a good series to have on the channel. And like I said, it has a place in my heart because it is one of the reasons I got into watching Let's Plays, so... But I will say... Stay still. I will definitely say it's I Let's make sure we get rid of these ones first. Having to... get rid of the troublesome ones first. Oh no. That's fine, that's fine. I'm tapping for dear life. I'm not even using anti-grav the way it should be used. Oh, come on. Nothing yet. We might have to throw our bombs down here at some point. Where is that? Oh no. We did it. I don't think we're gonna beat the final boss, unfortunately. As long as we don't summon any enemies, we should be fine. You, that negates the fact that we took a heart of damage. Oh, we did it. I'm so glad we went to that curse room and got Gimpy. It's pretty much might be the reason that and Dark Bomb might be the reason we make it through this. Creep, watch out for creep, watch out for creep. So you can't stand anywhere that's red. What the hell hit me? Oh. The turret in the middle. I didn't see it. We made it to the item room. Just giving me some HP. The wafer is really good. So this lets you take half damage from anything that would, you know, make you take more than half damage. I wonder if I can get three. I don't think you... maybe. No. Just gotta make sure I don't take a hit. What's this? Justice gives me consumables. One of which being a red heart. We're slowly building. Ooh, and a tainted rock. So this is a good place to use bombs. Let's put it like a bit over here. Oh damn it! I used my card. It's okay. There's another room down here, so it's the foot. Oh no! It's dropped me somewhere else on the floor. So there's two double key rooms, which is really interesting. I need to beat this room. You just gotta keep moving. 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 You got, that's the trick to this one. You just gotta keep moving. Whoo! We did it. And we got a black heart. Oh, it's our friend, Chubb. Okay, black heart, anything for me? There's so many key rooms. How are there so many key rooms? I don't understand. double key rooms tend to have a good chance of being great. So we're gonna risk it and go for the double key rooms. What's in here? What's in door number one? Key. No keys, but got a bomb, a spirit heart. Health up is amazing. I might take that later. That was a really good room. I'd be stupid to do the boss trap room unless there's an item in the... Ooh, that's tempting. It's going to be a long run. Luckily, unlike some of my other series that I'm hoping to put, or videos I'm hoping to put on this... E is bomb, right? E is bomb. Got a card there. Let's hope for it. Good. The moon card takes us to the secret room, where we get some more money. Is there a shop here? Make sure you don't get hit by this thing. Red fires can shoot you. Where does this take us? It doesn't take us anywhere. Good. Okay. We're gonna go back. Not there. Alright, so we found one secret room. And there's a key there. We're gonna use another bomb here. And we're gonna leave. And despawn them. We're gonna put a bomb here. And... nothing. We're gonna put a bomb here and hopefully get another card. Yes, we got a card. We're gonna leave. Come back in. We got the magician, which is homing tears. Could be really good. We've got two keys left, see? We can either go... well, this is a shop, right? Has to... oh, no. My worst... literally, the worst thing that could happen is we weren't able to buy another key. Oh, and we took some damage. Although, he gave us a lot of money, and we got another spirit heart, so we really would like to go to that room, and the only way I can see that happening is if there's a second secret room here, but it's almost unfathomable that there's a secret room there, yes. So our only other play left before we have to fight the boss is to open these. You know what? This can work. Money. Buy this one. Eternal heart and the key. And we just need to play this and get the key. In fact, I'm gonna pop one. I don't know what our lock stat is. There's many stats in this game. But got a bomb, not that useful. Got a penny, we just need one more key. Oh. Got 33 cents. I can keep doing this. Ooh, it's a health up pill. I don't think we need it. Ooh, actually. That is... we have Guppy's Paw. So we get that 6 extra spirit heart. Yeah, I don't want to say we've won this, because I could still royally mess this up on the final boss. But, oh, we've got a key. This run... I don't think this is a good run. But we've somehow made it work. I don't know what that does. We're going in here. 5 is... I don't know what 5 is, and it scares me. I think 5 is... that is basically a dice room, and it... I shouldn't do this, but I learned from... okay. We're going to use up all our money. Although... I think 5 is a get me now. So it makes you redo the whole run. Oh, that's not a good deal. Sorry, I'm trying to weigh up the options. I know, basically, I follow, there's one main Let's Player I watch for The Binding of Isaac. And he tends to do things a little bit more on the crazy side. So I know what he would do if this was him. But unfortunately, he has thousands of hours in this game and probably has a lot of muscle memory when it comes to this game that he can basically autopilot. I have not ascended to that level yet, so... But I still want to follow his teachings, if that makes sense. Oh, and we got the dollar bill, which gives us 99 cents, and we've unlocked... We're actually getting a lot of stuff done this match. See, here's the plan. If I use Guppy's paw, it'll take me to full. And then is it? I forget, is Bad Trip a health up? It's a full health, isn't it? But you know what? We're in a really good position. In fact, I'm gonna go in here. Oh, that was bad. That's fine. Well, this is not smart, but no regrets, because this is what the content I'm used to watching. Oh no, it's actually a boss room. So that is Loki. We won't have met him yet, unless you were crazy enough to do this level. Yes, it's yours. That bump. One boss. Oh no. It's Monstro. Oh, you jumped over my... It's all good. We're actually doing really well. So tanky. I feel like we're actually getting a lot better. It's becoming second nature. This is what Ultra Instinct feels like. And I was hoping to maybe, you know, have a few runs recorded for today. Just, you know, I thought it'd take me a couple of attempts to try and get a decent victory. Oh, no, we're still fine. It's all good. It only took like two. Okay, we got two cards. Lovers. That's really good. Dark Bomb, that's all you. And another lover's card. That's all you two. I'm going to keep the magician card. So, we've done the crazy play. Oh, almost used my key there. I'm tempted to take bad trip. Isn't bad trip... No, health down is health up. Right, I think. Bad trip is full health, but we don't have any red hearts. So, we're going to do the crazy play and extend this and reroll. And this is going to make us do the level all over again. Just because... why not? And I'm actually really proud of myself right now because I expected myself to do terribly in this. Need to clear a path. Oh, we're not even that strong. I can't say that without actually seeing the stats, but we don't have that option available to us as of this version of the game. Oh, we are. Oh, damn. Oh, no. Took a lot more damage than necessary. But we've got a... I wonder if I can get two from here. So these blue fires have a chance of dropping these spirit hearts, which they did not drop. But that is, I guess, something a truly new player probably wouldn't know. But luckily, we do. So I'm going to attempt to... That's not bad. I'm just... taking my time to enjoy this because I don't think we're gonna film anything else. What happened? I have no idea. Ooh, we got Scatol, which protects us. Scatol? That protects us from flies, which at this point in the game means nothing because we're very late in. Take that. You can have that one. Actually, we should save some money to go to the shop. I almost forgot. And since we've got some spirit hearts, I'm going to go in here and try and open this. And we got another spirit heart, so that's pretty good. I think this is in the bag. We don't, as long as we don't, like, take... Oh god, take too much damage. Oh, my fly protected me there. I don't even... what are those pills? How do I drop? I don't actually know how to drop items. How do I drop items? You know what? Sorry for this, but I need to figure this out. Just give me 1 second. How to drop items in Binding of Isaac. How to drop consumables, pills. How to drop pills. Come on, show me. Control key? You know what? Oh well. We're just gonna... So, here's how we're gonna do it. We're gonna walk and get all of these. That was worth. So, we got a fly from it, which is a protector. And we're gonna get the other one. And then we're gonna give another... And then we're going to leave it at that for the moment. Oh, no. It's not. I really don't have that much damage to be able to do this. Making so many more enemies. Alright, he's almost dead. We got him. And that boss gave us so much trouble at the start. But I think we're in a good... these guys. And don't forget the turret in the middle. Well, thank you, Gimpy, for that. My survivability items have definitely saved me so much this game. You can't stand on the tracks that they leave behind. Oh god. Gotta keep moving. Gotta keep moving. Even. Only one. Only one. Two. 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 Do I have a three? Do I have a three? We do not. Don't forget the second one. Good if we have chests. Can't be greed again, right? Yes, it's not greed. We've got so many bombs. Oh, is that good? Probably not. Alright. That shop was a wash. Oh my god. Oh, they crossed the threshold, so. Cheese this win from them. It's the first double boss room I've ever had to face. This game keeps you on edge, which I'm liking. Like, definitely it's different from just watching someone play or watching someone good play. They make it look so easy. So yeah, I think we're gonna keep at it, and we're gonna try and complete 100% this game. Or I think on this game they call it 1,000,000%. Are you dead yet? We're dead. They're dead. Right? Are these permanently down? No, they're not. Which is fine, because I'll put that there. And we will put this here. It's fine. Where else can we go? This way. Oh, we need to kill that guy. Those things, the white skulls cannot be hurt. They die when the last enemy in the room is dead. And we got two bombs, which is really good. We're doing okay. Like, our health is still pretty high. We haven't gone much. Our range is pretty good. We need to carefully navigate this room. Oh, that chest almost pushed me away. Oh, no. Damn it. Secret rooms. Possibly one up here. Nope. Oh my god. Why is my map so big? Control? Shift? Tab. I was wondering why. Okay. Oh. We've almost completed this floor. could be a secret room here. There was not. 7 bombs. We're still doing pretty good. There can't be a secret room up there or there. I haven't done this room down here. So let's finish this off. Golden key. These fire bombing shots. Oh. That makes your tears explode. Which can be good. Yeah, just have to think, what would the guy I follow do? And sadly, he would take it. As long as you stand far away from these, you should be fine. First boss. Oh, it's Monstro, our friend of the channel. Ugh. How? What? The good thing is they leave some fire behind, so if they explode, you can... too many hits. See, that is what you need to avoid. Lay him onto fire. Oh, that was just terrible. But, get anything from that? No. So it really wasn't that good of a room. Could be a secret room there. I've got 5 bombs. Have I been into the cursed room? I don't think I have. I think I have, actually. Right. Well, we have this. We're going to play this. And, oh. What's that? A pretty fly? No! Yes. Okay. We didn't use our magician card. That is our trump card for the final boss. Without that, we may be doomed. I'm surprised I haven't found the secret room yet. Sorry if this is a bit... I don't want to say... I think the term is min-maxi? Or min-maxi? I'm not trying... No, you know what? I'm a beginner. I'm doing everything I can to win, so I don't feel too bad about just taking every opportunity I can to make my run as good as it can be. Admittedly, I don't think this helps that much. Let's get another dollar bill. Okay. We've got 2 dollar bills in one game. That is pretty incredible. I wonder if I was kind of hoping that Gimpy would, you know, sort me out, but that is it. I think we can put a bomb here. We can put a bomb here. We can put a bomb here. Really nothing. We can put a bomb here. I don't think I'll have the coordination to use my bombs for, you know, against the boss, which is why I'm kind of just using them here. Oh, I really shouldn't, but you know, this is where it could go all wrong. I'll give it 1 spirit heart. Two spirit hearts. This is you know. Okay, no, we can't go any further. said, that I'm so confused. I'm like, where could the secret room be? Because we tried here, right? I feel like we tried there. Doesn't it leave a? I don't think it leaves a mark any on this one. I think that's on the later games where it remembers where you've been. Right, we're just gonna fight the boss then. So this is, I believe, Mom's Foot. It's the first part of completing the game. And I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you. We're just gonna try our best. We're gonna pop homing tears. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's not so good. Oh, I gotta make sure I don't. We just gotta watch out for the shadow. When the shadow appears. When the shadow appears, the foot comes down, and you've got to dodge the foot. Luckily, we somehow didn't take damage there. Isaac. And I think we're going to do it this time. So, first run of the series. And we've managed to pull a win.
Isaac was called.
We did it.
His mother, fueled with the desire to serve her god, was bearing down on Isaac. I will do as I'm told, my lord. I love you above all else, Isaac's mother repeated to herself. This was the end of the line for Isaac. His mother was far too strong for him. But just as he accepted his fate, God intervened, sending an angel down from above to stop his mother's hand. And just like that, it was over.
Or was it? Holy! Thought I'd let it play out since it's our first time completing the first section of the game. Ooh, that was actually quite a rush. I really wasn't expecting to get to the end of the first part of the game. But yeah, great first episode to the series. Hopefully we can keep it going. As you saw, we've unlocked a lot of new things, new bosses, and also a new area that I would say spoilers, but the game's been out for 4 years. So, after you fight Mom now, you can go to the following area and fight some more bosses and continue the game. But that will be for the next episode, and we got quite lucky this time. I can't guarantee that we'll get that far in the next run, but yeah. Great first episode. Hope you enjoyed it. This is my Binding of Isaac Let's Play series. Thanks for watching. If you did enjoy the episode, don't forget to hit the like button. If you want to see more, I'm sure I'm going to be making more on this game. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.